Hello, beautiful people. This is Chris from Macombe, and I'm here in a very... Hello, beautiful people. This is Chris from Macombe, and I'm here in a very crowded, very noisy Oppo launch room where they've just revealed the Oppo RX17 Pro and the Oppo RX17 Neo. I'm here with the Neo version. This is basically the light version of the Pro. It supports a very similar front-filling 6.4-inch display, but they've tweaked the design and the specs to shave a bit of money off the asking prices. It's €349 compared with the €599 Pro model. Now, first of all, for a €399 smartphone, gorgeous design. As you can see, I believe it's like 91.7% of the front of this phone is screen. And as you can see there, tiny little bezels, especially beneath the display. And up top, you've just got this little dewdrop style notch as well. So very little intrusion onto that screen. It's a full HD display, so nice and crisp. And as you can see, quite punchy. But certainly those colors are coming through nice and vividly. And the maximum brightness as well, very impressive indeed. So top brightness now, and it's certainly doing a fine job of countering the extremely harsh overhead lighting, which is currently melting my scalp. Flip it around, and the Neo version doesn't have the same very sexy frosty finish of the Pro model, but as you can see there, you still get the lovely gradient coloration. It's once again made of glass, and as you can see there, it gets kind of greasy and scuffy quite easily. Just try wiping off my pants, see if that helps. There you go, that's a bit better. You can pick it up in this lovely, as I say, gradient finish, blue down to purple. Otherwise, you can also pick it up in a sexy red hue as well. Great stuff. Even though this is the light version, the Neo model, you still get that in-screen fingerprint sensor, which is pretty nifty. And you also get a nice bit of facial recognition with this model as well. So if for whatever reason you can't get that fingerprint sensor to work, just aim your mug at it and hopefully that'll do the job instead. So you see, you can use the screen to illuminate your face if it is low light conditions, so hopefully that will still help. And you can unlock it directly with your face as well. So let's just give it a quick test now. Now tap that power button, as you can see, straight into the desktops, no hanging about. And hopefully that fingerprint sensor will do a job as well. Yeah, no worries at all. As for the actual specs themselves, they are pared down slightly from the Pro version, but you still get a Snapdragon 660 in there, backed by 4GB of RAM. So far, performance seems absolutely fine on that ColorOS overlay. Just like the Pro version, you do get latest ColorOS 5.2. As you can see there, that's slathered on top of Android version 8.1.0, so no Android Pie yet, but hopefully that will be coming shortly. Of course, this adds the usual plethora of bonus features. You've got all kinds of stuff, so you can completely tweak the display to match your liking. What you don't seem able to do is actually get an app store back in action, unfortunately. You'll have to assign your own launcher if you want to do that. The smart convenience section has a few nifty bits in here. So you can play around with the navigation keys. You can turn on the smart size bar. All you need to do is just drag it out like so, and as you can see, you've got fast access to the likes of taking a screenshot and some of your most used applications. It's got the usual gesture controls, of course, and gamer's delight. Nice bit of game space action in there as well, so you can get your games added in there. As you see, you can do graphics acceleration, and the game assistant is pretty handy as well. You can pull out all kinds of settings while you're actually gaming. And oh my god, my voice is already going, and this is only the first one I've done a hands-on with. I've still got another one after this. Ah, plenty of storage packed away on there as well. As you see, 128 gigs, very little of that in fact has been used. It's got quite a lot available. I don't believe it's got micro SD memory card support, however, but that should still do you just fine. As for the battery, it's a 3600 milliamp cell, so hopefully it should give you at least a full day of battery life, even with plenty of playtime. Sadly, I don't believe this has the VOOC Plus charging system, which the Pro model does, which can charge you up to about 40% level with just 10 minutes at the charger, but hopefully it should still be relatively swift. Which brings us nicely onto the camera tech, and as you can see there, you've got a dual lens snapper slapped on the back, and if you've used it up front before, you'd be right at home with the camera app. As you can see, just opening your photo mode, you can quickly flick between the other modes, portrait mode, sticker mode, hooray, who doesn't like random stickers? Oh look, I can turn myself into, I don't know what the shit that is. Got bananas on my cheeks for some reason. Oh, ice creams now, lovely. Or a pretty princess, ready for the ball. Kill it with fire. You've got full Pro controls, of course, should you need them. So you can play around the shutter speed, autofocus, ISO levels, white balance, yada yada. And of course you can shoot the usual time lapse, and in video mode you can flick between 1080p, 720p and good old 4K. With of course a good bit of beauty mode action. should you require that? I don't actually know the specs of the rear camera, unfortunately. They have neglected to tell us that. All I can tell from sort of digging around in the settings and stuff is that it's an f1.7 aperture. So it won't be quite as good, I imagine, as the Pro version at those low light shots, but still hopefully do a decent enough job. And if you look to the front facing camera, it's actually a 25 megapixel selfie camera. They have told us that much. You can't shoot 4K video, unfortunately, only up to full HD. But hopefully should do the job for those selfie shots. Depth effect, sorry, just hidden away up there at the top rather than a portrait mode, especially down bottom, so as you can see there. Oh yeah, it's been a long day, people. Don't judge me too harshly. So that right there in a nutshell is the RX17 Neo edition. No idea on UK price or release date just yet. Hopefully be able to bring that to you soon. But hopefully that's given you all you need to know. Definitely hit us up with any comments, questions. We get in touch with the Oppo PRs to try and get some proper full-on specs out of them. So hopefully questions about the actual camera hardware and all that will be answered shortly. As ever, hit subscribe, ding the notification bell, and have yourselves a lovely final day. Love you, bye!